Greetings, loved ones.
Hi, my name is Gina Fiorino, and I'm here to talk to you about a legendary food item God graces us with, the McRib. So if you don't know the McRib...
Hi, I'm Ashley Patel.
And I'm Ava Cheney, and you don't think we look alike?
This is Wavy, and if you want to give me some betting money, please.
Hi, my name is Josie Jacob.
Hi, I'm Tenley Isler.
And I'm Kavya Patel.
And Christina, are you there?
All right, I'm Aiden McKendrick. Shout out Deca. And it's a great day to be a Wildcat.
This is Evan Winnia, Gavin Moore, and we're in Deca.
Hi, I'm Emma Pietmeyer.
I'm Allison Sider.
And I'm Lauren Holland, and this is our favorite Deca advisor.
I'm Eric Frio. I signed up for this class to go to New York City and never went.
Hi, I'm Jocelyn, and my partner left me for college this year.
Hi, I'm Corinne.
I'm Natalie.
I'm Kristen.
And Mr. Dersham thinks we're triplets.
Hooray!
We're your 2023 Deca seniors, and you're watching What's Up Wildcats.
Big rip for life!
Hello, Harrison High School, and welcome to What's Up Wildcats. I'm Jaylee R.
And I'm Carter Fry. Today is Thursday, April 20th. Here's what's going on.
Tomorrow and Saturday at 7 p.m. is the Harrison High School's Creative Arts Theater's spring production of Mamma Mia. You can purchase tickets online at the price of $10 for students and seniors and $12 for adults. QR codes to purchase the tickets are located across the school. They look forward to seeing you this weekend.
Seniors, nominations for senior superlatives have been compiled, and now it is time to vote for your choice among the nominees. Any nominee who would like his or her name removed should contact Mr. Ward or Ms. Hinterong ASAP. Please cast your vote for senior superlatives by clicking the link, which can be found in the Class of 23 Teams page.
All students and staff will be participating in the Day of Service later in May. This is a day to complete service projects throughout our community. Students, you must check your Class of Teams page and select between two options by April 28th. Option one is to complete an online survey indicating your requests for a service project with a high school teacher. Option two allows you to create and complete your own project, but you must get a permission form from Mrs. Hasnor in room 237 if you select option two. All important information has been posted in the Class of Teams page. You must complete the survey or return your permission form by April 28th. Message Mrs. Hasnor with any questions.
Have you been accepted to a college and declared a fine arts major or minor? If so, you are invited to be recognized at the Fine Arts Signing Day. This ceremony will celebrate students who will continue to be involved in the arts at a collegiate level with signed letters of intent. The deadline to register is May 1st. Check with your art or music teacher for the link or go to the high school Twitter and Facebook pages.
Your favorite varsity softball team won their ninth consecutive game yesterday in another dominant fashion, beating league opponent Talawanda 11-3 at their place. Reigning co-pitcher of the year, Sophie Barrier pitched a great game, holding a talented team to just three hits and no run before the Brave plated three in the fifth to avoid a run rule. She had five Ks and was 2-3 at the dish with two RBI. Nice work, Soph. The hitting display was led by our three seniors. Ella Faffel was 4-5 with two doubles and two RBI. Cassidy Seeger was 3-5 with a double and a stolen base. Molly Hudler added two hits. Rookie Chloe Legner had two hits and a stolen base. AJ Lemel and Miley McKernan had two hits and a double each. Rookie Montana Yonker and Kristen Liggett each had a hit. The girls remain undefeated in league play in their attempt to repeat their undefeated league title from last season. They'll play a doubleheader tomorrow at home against Mount Healthy. Keep it hot, ladies.
The JV Wildcats softball were staged another thrilling comeback win as they defeated Little Miami 10-3 Wednesday at the Panthers' home field. Tying the game at 3 on Mo Miller's two-run single in the top of the sixth, the Cats clawed back from a 3-1 deficit. The Cardiac Cats beat behind some excellent starting work in the circle by Montana Yonker and outstanding relief pitching by Josie Harness shut down Little Miami as the catch pushed the game to extra innings. The Wildcat offense exploded in the eighth inning when seven Wildcats crossed the plate. Mo Miller led the Cats on the day with four hits. Reagan Allen had three, while Caden Baird, Aubrey Murphy, CeCe Bischoff, and Montana Yonker all smashed extra base hits and two hits apiece. The defensive highlights came from center fielder Reagan Allen's two ESPN quality diving catch plays of the day and some gritty tough play behind the plate from Mo Miller. Way to go, Wildcats.
On the menu at lunch tomorrow in the W Cafe is a deluxe chicken sandwich, green beans, tater tots, applesauce, fruit salad, and milk.
That's news for today. I'm Carter Fry.
And I'm Jaylee R. And on this date in 1916, the first National League baseball game is played at what is now known as Wrigley Field in Chicago.